Welcome to RMCA Bishop Channel. Hungary's parliament passed a law on Tuesday, 15 December 2020, defining the family as having a woman as the mother and a man as the father, effectively banning adoptions by same-sex couples and complicating adoptions by single people. The change is the latest of several to be made in recent years in what the government has said are attempts to preserve Hungary's Christian identity and to boost its plummeting birth rates. If we give up on our Christianity, then we will lose our own identity as Hungarians, as Europeans, Katalin Novak, Hungary's Minister for State for Family Affairs, told Catholic news agency last December. Roughly half of Hungary's population identifies as Roman Catholic, while about one-fifth identifies as Protestant or some other Christian denomination. Another fifth of the population identifies as having no religious affiliation, with Jewish, Muslim and other religious minorities making up the rest of the population. "We have a demographic challenge ahead of us," Novak said. While some countries may rely on immigration, Hungary is trying to reverse the trend with a two-pronged approach: financial incentives for families to have more children, and promoting a culture that is pro-life and welcoming large families, she added. Incentives to have children are built into the loan. One-third of it can be forgiven if the married couple has two children, and the entire loan can be forgiven if they have three children. Women with four or more children will be exempted from income tax for life. Families with at least three children are eligible for a grant to purchase a car that seats seven or more people. Hungary claims the policies are working, as its Central Statistics Office recently reported a 20% increase in marriages in 2019. Earlier this year, Hungary also passed a law declaring a person's gender to be that of their biological sex at birth, blocking attempts by transgender people to change their legal gender identity. The move was widely criticized by some as an attack on LGBT human rights. Critics have also said the policy changes passed this week are a dangerous expansion of power by Prime Minister Viktor Orban and his party, the New York Times reported. Hungary also sees part of its Christian identity in helping Christian victims of persecution in other countries. In Iraq, the government helped resettle Christian genocide victims through its aid program, Hungary Helps, providing more than $3 million for the effort. "We are in the first place responsible for our own people, and if they need more help in order to be able to raise more children and have family, then we have to provide this help," she said. Now the question is, can a woman be a father and a man be a mother? I know that this question itself looks so funny, because we are living not that way. This is the way we are taught, that a woman is a mother, a man is a father. And this is the way we are teaching our children. And this is what we are living. If some try to teach differently, then it may take time to convince the people. We need time to examine the veracity of the arguments and the facts placed. So let us not jump into any conclusion. No one can impose an opinion on anybody. At the same time, as in the past, we need to be open to new ideas and different way of looking at things. We don't need to be first always to burn the fingers. Therefore, wait and watch. Till then, let the woman continue to be the mother and man continue to be the father. For the time being, that is better to maintain the harmony in the family. That's all for today, my dear. Now I am going to give you my blessing. May Almighty God bless you and your family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A soft reminder to RMCA followers who listen daily. Please listen to talks daily. It will help you and you will stay blessed. Please do keep me also in your prayers. Please look at the screen of your mobile now and see if the word subscribe is still in red color. Please touch it gently and make it black. Thank you. Now, may I request you for a help, please? Kindly send this talk to your selected 5 friends who probably may appreciate and benefit from it. Because Jesus said, don't throw pearls in front of. Once again, God bless you. Wish you a good day. Humbly, always in the mission of the Lord, in the Lord and the Church, Bishop Franco Mulacchio.